بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ومن والاه وبعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. All thanks and praise are due to Allah رب العزة والجلال. We thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى for each and every favor Allah سبحانه وتعالى continuously bestow upon us. We thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى for the greatest favor of all, making us the carriers of His kalima لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We send our peace and salutations upon our beloved Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, his family, his friends, his companions, and all those that follow his guidance. Alhamdulillah, just excuse me for a minute. Try net gou my asem te kry. Ek het heeltemal vergiet. Strange, ek het vergiet ek goed baie gedag. Toe sit ek by die huis, toe sien ek is 20 to 1. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, beloved brothers and sisters in Islam. We continue with the talk which I gave the last time I spoke, I think 2 weeks ago, when we spoke about the power of dua. And firstly, we should remind ourselves that we cannot become desensitized. Because usually what happens is when a person sees something too much, when you see too much of something, you become used to that thing. So we have seen, and actually a sister out of Gaza, she sent a message and she said, the world is rather going quiet. We don't see so much protest anymore. People are not posting as much on the status anymore, except for a select few. But we should never ever become desensitized to this. The call is still for our brothers and sisters in Palestine. We should still supplicate to Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants them victory. And as we have said, that is the very least that we can do for them. Now the last time we spoke, we ended off when Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu wassalam, when we said he was caught in three layers of darkness. He was caught in layers of darkness. And then he called out to Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal to show us the power of dua. And at times, we as human, at times, we sometimes forget that that is the best weapon ever. There is no better weapon than dua. And sometimes it is the unassuming person, the person that we never ever thought of. It is that person when he raises his hands and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts his dua. So the dua is not expected from a select few, but rather it is the responsibility of each and every person from the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make dua for our brothers and sisters all around the world, but more especially in Gaza. And the Mufassirun, there is a difference of opinion among the Mufassirun when they discuss the period that Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam was in the belly of the fish. However, that is not relevant now, but rather what we want to look at is what did Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, and can we just for 1 second sit still and think, what was it like? What was it like? That was an environment no human have ever experienced. That was a darkness no human has ever experienced. And what would we do if we were in a situation like that? But rather Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, Ya Rabbi, ittakhadtu laka masjidan fi mawdi'in lam yablughu ahadun minan nas. He called out to Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal and he said, Ya Allah, I've made a masjid in this place that I find myself in. Meaning in that dark place, in the darkness of the ocean, in the darkness of the night, he still found time to perform 2 rak'ahs of salah. And immediately after his salah, he called out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He called out to Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal for help. And that should be by default. For every single person, that should be the default. Whenever we are faced with any difficulty, whenever we are faced with any difficulty, whether it is for the akhirah or whether it is for matters of this dunya, that should be the default. Even before we go, yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sometimes people, they quote it with, they say, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the men of remembrance. Every field has its masters. Every field has its men. But even before we go to that people to seek help, the very first thing is, turn to Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dua. And what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in regards to Nabi Yunus? What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the Quran? Regarding the time he spent in the belly of the fish, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِي إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Allah says, if he was not one that made tasbih to me, if he was not one that performed salah to me, if he was not one that supplicated to me, if he was not one that made dua and reached out to me, Allah says, I would have left him there until the day of Qiyamah. So what saved Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, and not only him, but all the other Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam? What saved them? What did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what did he do at the Battle of Badr? Allahumma in tahlika hadhi al-isabatu la tu'badu fil ardi abada. They were outnumbered by so much. Exactly what is happening now in Palestine. They were outnumbered by so many, and in many other battles. He said, oh Allah, if this group of men, if this 330 men are destroyed today, never on the face of the earth will you be worshipped again. To the point where the rida that he was wearing, the cloak that he was, it fell off the back of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he came from behind and he said, Hasbuk ya Rasulullah. He said, that's enough Rasulullah. Allah has already promised us victory. Even though the victory was promised, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he still called out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the importance of dua. To show us there is no greater weapon. Numbers never ever mattered by Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. Numbers never ever matter. Even if the whole world should come together to harm one person, if the decree of Allah is not there, it will not happen. Exactly the same, if the whole world should come together to benefit someone, it will never happen unless Allah has decreed it so. So we should make it second nature. It should be a part of us. Whenever we are faced with any problem, the very first thing we do is we perform two rak'ahs of salah. We turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a broken heart, and we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and by Allah, Allah will send his assistance. Maybe not immediately. Maybe not immediately. And to us on the outside, if we look at the whole situation, what is happening in Gaza, to us it seems as a terrible thing. But I maintain and I say every day that there is more khair coming out of this war than harm. People are taking their shahada by the thousands. Because of them, what is happening to that people in Gaza? Yes, we see it as something bad, but yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is honoring them. Allah is using them to teach the world. Allah is using them as a means for hidayah. Allah is using them as a means for da'wah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using them in so different ways, so many different ways. I say it every day, we should worry, what will our end be like? How will my end be like? How will I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They, alhamdulillah, they are not in limbo. They are shuhada. They have the loftiest of stations. Where will the shuhada be? They will be amongst the anbiya. Every child that has lost his life or her life, they will wait at the doors of Jannah. They will wait at the doors of Jannah. And it will be asked, what are you people waiting for? Why are you waiting here? They will say, I am waiting on my parents. I will not enter until my parents accompany me. What a great honor is that. So for us on the outside, we don't understand. We don't understand. Oh, we must remember one thing. Allah's system is perfect. Allah never makes mistakes. Whatever is happening is not by coincidence. It's not by coincidence. It was always part of Allah's plan. It was always part of Allah's plan. What about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Where he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said it himself. He said, one of the darkest days, one of the days that I felt the most hurt was the day of Ta'if. Was the day of Ta'if. When he was stoned and he was mocked and he was spat on and the blood was flowing. Some narrators, they say, his beard sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it looked as if somebody squeezed pomegranate juice on the beard of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The way the blood was flowing from him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was trying to stop the blood from reaching the ground, the earth. Why? Any piece of ground that the blood of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam is spilled on, that land becomes cursed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we know the story. Allah appointed the malak of the mountains. And Allah says, ya, Allah tells the malaika, whatever Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked for now, you carry it out immediately. You carry it out immediately. And this malak, he was waiting. He was waiting. And he said, I will fold this people of Ta'if. I will fold the two mountains on them. And what did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he do in this darkest hour? This is the lesson. What did he do in this darkest hour? Allahumma inni ashku ilayka da'fa quwwati. He turned to Allah. He first performed two units of prayer. And said, ya Allah, I turn to you regarding my weakness. The people drove him out. He didn't blame the people. He didn't blame the people. He turned to Allah and said, ya Allah, I turn to you. I complain to you, ya Allah, about my weakness. And my helplessness, ya Allah, I turn to you. Ya Allah, will you put in charge of me somebody that will oppress me, somebody that will dominate me? And it's a lengthy hadith. Until the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِلَّمْ تَكُنْ غَبَّانًا عَلَيَّ. He said, Allah, as long as you are not angry with me, فَلَا أُبَالِي, then I don't care. Whether they hit me and kick me and stone me and drive me out, I don't care. As long as you are not angry with me, as long as you are not angry, then I don't care. فَلَا أُبَالِي. But he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَعَافِيَتَكَ أوسعلي. But he said, regardless of this, ya Allah, your divine help and your afia, it is easier for me. So that is the least that we can do for our brothers and sisters in Palestine. We can call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and complain to Allah about our weakness, how we are unable to help them. And we can say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Allah, with all our weakness, we still turn to you, ya Allah. We still turn to you. And we supplicate and we cry to you, ya Allah, help our brothers and sisters in Palestine. And through our du'as and the du'a of the entire ummah, the du'as of the entire ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's help will come. Allah's help will come. So we should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should use this weapon. This is the weapon of a mu'min. This is the best weapon ever. Is the weapon of a Muslim. As-silahu al-mu'min, al-du'a. The weapon of a believer is what? It is his du'a. So let us turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is so much I wanted to say, but we've ran out of time. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, just to tell us when to make dua. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ثِنْتَانِ لَا تُرَدَّانِ. He said, there are two times when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never rejects dua. He said, الدُّعَى عِنْدَ النِّدَى. The dua that is made after the adhan. After that, the call to prayer has been given, that dua. He said, لا تردني أو قلما. أو قلما تردان. He said it is never rejected or very seldom is it rejected. That dua after the adhan. And the second one is when? عند البأس حين يلحم بعضهم بعضا. Or when combatants are engaged in warfare. So we can call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, our brothers and sisters, they are engaged 24 hours a day in warfare. Ya Allah, we call out to you for your assistance, Ya Allah. We call out for your assistance, Ya Allah. We make dua. That is, we are merely weak believers. We are weak. We are extremely weak, Ya Allah. But we cry to you and we turn to you, seeking your help for our brothers and sisters in Gaza. We will end off with a hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, لِيَسْأَلْ أَحَدَكُمْ رَبَّهُ حَاجَتَهُ حَتَّى يَسْأَلَهُ الْمِلْحَ وَحَتَّى يَسْأَلَهُ شِسْعَ نَعْلِهِ إِذَا انْقَطَعَ رواه الترمذي. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, you should ask your Lord for everything you need. And this is a hadith that should stay with us always and should remind us that the Raziq, the Helper, the helper, the maker, the breaker, the everything, it is Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. Nothing moves in this earth without not even the atom. It does not move except with the permission of Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's ordering us and he's telling us, you ask Allah for everything. He says, even if it is, the strap of your sandal when it breaks, ask Allah for help. Ask Allah, even if it is the strap of your sandal, ask Allah's help. Even if you need some salt for your food, ask Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. If we do that with true yaqeen and with sincerity, Allah will solve each and every problem in our life. Allah will fulfill each and every need that we need. Everything that we need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, ادعوني استجب لكم. Call out to me, I will answer you. I am waiting for you to call. But today we call on everyone else besides Allah. Go to the source. Go to the source himself. Ask Allah. Ask Allah before you ask people. First ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant our brothers and sisters that are fighting in this war. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them victory. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them victory over the enemies of Islam, over the enemies of Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant each and every one of us to stand one day in a liberated Masjid al-Aqsa. Wa akhiru da'wana anilhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. First of all, a begging dua for all the deceased, all marhum and marhumin, the sick and every person not experiencing the best of health, whether at home or in hospital. A special dua goes out for our secretary, that's Ruzda, and the mother as well. They are both currently in hospital. And we are always make continuous dua for our people of Palestine. Last week, we've done a collection drive. I said to our treasurer that we're going to still keep it another week. There's still people doing EFTs. We're currently standing on about 13,500. So by next week, we will read out how much money was collected. And the proceeds will go to gifts of the givers. Our first collection drive was given to Islamic Relief. This collection will go to gifts of the givers, inshallah. We wish to thank the community for the generous donations and contribution. Last week, Jumba collection was 6,355. Introduction to Aqeedah classes is still on by Sheikh Junaid Ramad on a Wednesday evening between Maghrib and Isha. The Qurban booklets for 2024 are still available. You can contact Ibrahim and Haj Sadiq Peterson. It's a notice by the Baitul Mal committee that they will be closing the 29th of November, that's this Wednesday. That will be the last food distribution for this year until further notice, inshallah. And once again, they say shukran for all the sponsors for their generous for their support, inshallah. Then I just received a notice, a Umrah notice from Haj Ahmad Brown. He's a ex-resident from Strandfontein. He's currently staying in Pelican Heights. He said, Alhamdulillah, with the Qudrat Allah, myself, Ahmad, and Habiba Brown, they will be bid salam for the parts of Umrah, inshallah. Please forgive us if we have harmed you in any way. Amin, Rabbil Alameen. I'll keep it short because of time. The departure date is the 28th of November. The leaving residence, 10 a.m. for a 13:50 flight, inshallah. We will ask our مولانا وشيخ تمك دعاء إن شاء الله. جزاك الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
I'm sorry now for this, man. I totally forgot to forward the details. Just to request also the Jamaat to make dua for my mother-in-law, Jefaldila Martin. She's been in Khurutski this entire week. She had her up on Wednesday as well, inshallah. Please keep her in her du'as. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her shifa and kamilin. Jazakum Allah khairan.
Allah, 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 All إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله البر الجواد الذي جلت نعمه عن الإحصاء بالعداد المان باللطف والإرشاد الهادي إلى سبيل الرشاد الموفق للتفقه في الدين من لطف به واختاره من العباد. أحمده أبلغ حمد وأكمله وأزكاه وأشمله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، أوصيكم ونفسي أولا بتقوى الله، فقال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: كل بني آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التواب. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولوالدي ولوالديكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم زد وأدم وأنئم وتفضل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك وأشرف عبادك سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفينا وسندنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل الصحابة أجمعين.
الحمد لله عم جودي كل موجود، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة أرغم بها عن كل مشرك وجحود، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صاحب المقام المحمود. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أهل الكرم والجود. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، اتقوا الله تعالى فيما أمر وانتهوا عما نهى عنه وزجر، واعلموا أن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه، فقاله تعالى ولم يزل قائلا عليما: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وسائر أصحاب نبيك أجمعين والتابعين التابعين
ومن
تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك واجعل بلدنا آمنا رخاء صخاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين يا رب العالمين.
يا مولانا
اللهم تب على التائبين واغفر ذنوب المذنبين واقض الدين عن المدينين واشف مرضى المسلمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعيدكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة، قوموا إلى صلاتكم.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullah. Brothers, our caretaker Abdul Razak is leaving us the end of the month, end of the year, inshallah. So we have put out the CVs for the position of caretaker for the masjid. I did put in mine, but let's say Sukiman Yongara. So inshallah, just put your CVs this Friday, the 30th of this month, and the CVs to be handed over to Buta Ibrahim, inshallah. Shukran jazilan, Sheikh.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استووا واعتدلوا يرحمكم الله. استووا صفوفكم. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم، غير المغضوب عليهم ولا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك، فإن مع العسر يسرا، إن مع العسر يسرا، فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب.
الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله العظيم الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم ونتوب إليك ونسألك توبة ومغفرة إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وإلهكم إله واحد لا إله إلا
الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يئوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم يا علي يا عظيم سبحان الله. الحمد لله الله أكبر الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وإليه المصير إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين وقال ربكم ادعوني أستجب لكم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ربنا تقبل منا صلاتنا تامة واغفر لنا ذنوبنا عامة ولا تعذبنا يوم القيامة إنك على كل شيء قدير ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم اغفر لأهل القبور من المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات ارفع لهم الدرجات وكفر عنهم السيئات يا رب العالمين اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اعداء الدين واجعل هذا البلد آمنا رخاء سخاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وأهله في كل مكان اللهم احفظ الإسلام وأهله في فلسطين اللهم كن لإخواننا في فلسطين اللهم كن لهم مؤيدا وظهيرا اللهم فرج همهم اللهم انصرهم اللهم داوي جرحاهم اللهم عافي مبتلاهم واشف مرضاهم وارحم موتاهم وتقبل شهداءهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا ربنا العالمين ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا
وسلم على إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون بفضلك دعواهم فيها سبحان لك الله وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
Thank you.